pirate all pirates fear. Blackbeard!
Welcome to Neverland!
You play an awesome meanie.
Thanks. It's the real me.
Is it?
Oh, this nice guy act is exhausting. I can't even say it. It's exhausting. No, I loved it. Although I did say to my daughter, I ever said, oh, were you scared with the movie? Because it's a family movie and I was keen. She goes, oh, it's not scary. I said, yeah, but Blackbeard is a little. And she goes, Dad, you're not scary. Oh. I said, not even a little edgy? She goes, you, edgy? No.
For I have sprung you from life's cruel dungeon and hereby grant you liberty. Come unto me, you are home.
How did you feel sort of sporting that look while in real life, you know, when you weren't filming?
I loved it in real life. I loved it on set. In real life, I had this four-month period where no one recognised me. I really was walking around. I mean, a few people looked at me, not in a can I get a selfie, but more like, is he going to punch me up or could I score some drugs here? I was getting that kind of look. Very different for me. It worked for me at home because let's not forget Deb met me when I was playing a prisoner in Corelli. So fair to say the bad boys are more her type. Mm-hmm. So this somehow worked for me.
We have an ancient prophecy from when the fairy kingdoms reigned on this island. The prophecy tells of a boy born of the love between a fairy prince and a human girl. A boy who would be disappeared from this world until he was old enough to return and lead an uprising against me. A boy, so says the prophecy, who could fly.
Tell me about Levi Miller, the little boy who plays Peter. He's an Australian.
Yeah.
He's quite remarkable.
It's a great word, he's remarkable. He's got an old head on his shoulders. He's a phenomenal actor. I don't think he has any idea how good he is. I remember standing next to the camera, Seamus, the operator, and they called cut, and he had just done a scene. He had tears running down his face. And I looked at Seamus, and I was like, how good is this kid? And he goes, shh, don't say anything. Just let him do it. This was about 2 weeks from the end of shooting after about 6 months. And he was just having the time of his life. He's about to become one of the biggest things on the planet. And I'm so thrilled that he's so down to earth, he's so polite, so respectful, and it's effortless for him. I can see that he's completely in his element.
Listen.
Oh, what the bloody hell am I?
You can go feeling sorry for yourself all you want, kid, but knowing where you're from, that's half of knowing who you are. That's more than most of us here will ever know.
At least you know where you come from. Born to a warrior, heir to a prince. Does that mean you're the one? I don't know. I don't know if there is one. But I do know that if you aren't the guy, and you are just you, maybe that's enough.
When you saw the finished film, that must have been quite amazing, because obviously not all of it could be done in camera. What was your first impression when you actually saw it?
My first impression, and what I told Joe Wright, the director, was, man, before I tell you anything about the film, I just want to tell you, I feel like a little kid again. And I said, I'm not sure how you've achieved it, but if there's one thing that J.M. Barrie's book is about, is to never lose that childlike wonder, fearlessness, sense of adventure for life. Somehow as adults, we kind of lose it. It's a beautiful part at the end of the book where the grown-up Wendy talks about, I'm not sure where I stopped believing that I could fly, but I've even forgotten how that happened. And it was really poignant to me. And so this film has that. I think Joe, in his childlike spirit, the world is created, the visual sense of it, the sense of possibility, that there's a cheekiness to it and a lightness to it.
Come on, kid. Make them believe.
I believe.
Mermaid Lagoon.
I think you're gonna rock him.
You can say that again.